The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... In. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Welcome to the fear you can hear. Welcome to the sounds of suspense. Have you ever noticed the similarity between night driving and making your way through life? Driving at night, you can only see as far as your headlights show you the road. You never know what's over the next hill or around the next curve. And even on a straight road, your vision only extends as far as your lights. Life is very much the same. None of us really knows what lies ahead.
You look exactly like my husband, a dead ringer. Here, take a look at this picture.
Hey, that's scary. I didn't know two guys could look this much alike.
How would you like to be my husband?
No way. I like being who I am, Al Grissom.
But don't you see how easy it would be to take his place?
Yeah, you bet. But it's easier to stay away from murder.
Well, who said anything about murder?
You did, my lovely. And my answer is no way.
Our mystery drama, Dead Ringer, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Murray Burnett, and stars Leon Janney. It is sponsored in part by the Kellogg Company, makers of Kellogg's Special K cereal. I'll be back shortly with Act One. You're on a blacktop country road about 18 miles east of the little town of Eudalia. It's raining hard. You're driving a Citroën Maserati, and it handles. But you have your problems. You're going to be late for dinner, and you have a husband who doesn't appreciate lateness. The night seems to be getting blacker, and the rain shows no sign of easing.
Darn this rain. While I'm at it, darn the weatherman who promised clear and cool weather.
Your name is Gloria Winters. And then the headlights pick up something in the road. Whatever it is, it's a problem because it doesn't seem to move.
Come on, stupid, move. Get out of my way. Oh, my. Come on. What happened?
A car hit me and drove off. Thanks for stopping.
That's okay.
Well, a lot of people didn't.
Do you think you can make it to my car?
Yeah, with a little help.
Okay. There we go. Oh. That's it. Oh. Steady now.
Yeah, I guess I better...
Just slip into the seat.
Yeah.
There you go.
Thanks.
I'll close the door and come around the other side.
Watch yourself. There's some crazy guys driving this road. You're soaked.
And you are hurt. I'll take you to the Hermitage.
What's that?
The hospital.
Oh, no. No hospital.
You're bleeding.
Now, looks worse than it is. It's sure playing hell with your car, huh?
You must go to a hospital.
Oh, no. No way.
But why?
Because hospitals are for dying.
Oh, that's crazy.
Well, that's what everyone tells me.
Well, I don't care what
Look, I can't ever thank you enough for picking me up, but I have this thing about hospitals.
But you're really...
I promise you, I'm not going to die.
Okay, but where to?
The Three Coyotes Motel. It's just outside.
I know where it is.
Oh,
Doug, come on. Just put your head on the pillow and don't be a baby.
Oh, you're some dynamite kind of good Samaritan.
Well, I have a right to see what you look like under all that dirt and blood, haven't I?
No argument.
This may hurt.
Oh.
Hey. Well, now you're beginning to look like you have it perfectly.
It's that bad, huh?
Oh, no. It... It's nothing. I just thought of something.
Like what?
You look exactly like my husband. But I mean exactly. You could be identical twins. You don't believe me?
No, I believe you.
Well, that's why I got such a shock when I cleaned you up and got a good look at your face in the light. You're a dead ringer for Leo.
Oh. Why does that shake you up?
Leo and I are having our problems.
Isn't everybody?
I suppose. I'm just wondering...
Yeah?
Well, I'm wondering what you were doing walking down Route 38 in the rain at 6:15.
I missed the bus.
There's no bus on Route 38.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I did.
Okay, I suppose you've got a right to know the story. I live in Chicago. I'm a market analyst.
Come again?
I advise my customers about what to do or what not to do in the stock market. Sort of a securities specialist.
Are you, married?
Oh, no. But that's, part of the story. Years ago, I fell in love. She was from Chicago, too, but it didn't work out. You've heard the story 100 million times. You met someone. We said a sentimental goodbye. She cried. I felt sick. And we made the usual commitments. If she ever needs me, you know.
Romantic.
Mm-hmm. Romantic. Well, the day before yesterday, I got a call from her. She was living near Eudalia. She was in trouble.
What kind of trouble?
Well, it was private. And there'll be no names.
Okay, okay.
So I came. Naturally, she didn't want her husband to know. She didn't want my car to be seen by the neighbors. Well, you know how small towns are.
Yes, I know.
So I let her call the shots. She picked me up, drove me somewhere close to her house. She was supposed to drive me back, but her husband had called and said he was coming home early.
Well, where was he supposed to be?
It was on a business call. It would have kept him from getting home before 9. So our appointment was cut short. She panicked, and I walked, trying to thumb a ride. This widow came along, and pow, and you found me.
What a difference. What a difference. You look like Leo, but you were completely different. Leo wouldn't cross the street to help a blind, crippled kid find his crutch, while you...
And you stopped and picked up a stranger lying in the road.
Well, I told you that Leo and I don't get along.
But you married him.
I didn't know what it would be like. Anyway, what are you going to do now?
Oh, I'm going to change motels and lie low until I can go back to Chicago without having to explain the way I look.
What about the girl you came to help?
Oh, that was a bad scene. Well, nothing I can really do for her. She has a decision to make.
So have I. Will you help me to make it?
If I can.
Oh, you can, Al. You can. In a very big way.
I don't like it, Gloria. I don't like it at all.
You have been saying that for a whole week, Leo.
When's he going back to Chicago?
When the scars heal and nobody will ask questions.
How about the name of the girl he came to help?
He won't tell me.
I don't like it.
Oh, Leo, trust me.
Why?
Because I'm a woman.
If you could give me one good reason...
I've given you a million reasons. $1 million. Al is the man who can do it for us.
You really believe he's leveling about the securities market in his background? Maybe he's conning you.
Why?
Take a look in the mirror.
All right. Suppose he is playing me for a sucker.
Then we're...
We're still all right, maybe even better. Just trust me.
Do I have a choice?
You always have a choice. Don't ever forget that. You made one the day you married me. I do love you, Al.
Me too.
No, we have some serious
things. Come here.
Come on, I'll be serious.
We can't go on like this.
What?
Isn't that what you were going to be so serious about, Tony, that we can't go on like this?
Well, yes. How did you know?
Well, because people are more predictable than the stock market. And, darling, I've studied the market, and I know its moves.
Okay. Then continue.
With what?
What else I had to say?
Oh, it was going to go something like this. I told you I was fed up with Leo, and until you came along, I just didn't see any way out, but now...
You're doing super. Go on.
But now, if we love each other, I can divorce Leo, and we'll get married and live happily ever after. Right?
Not exactly.
Where'd I go wrong?
On the divorce.
You don't want to divorce Leo?
I know Leo. He'd never give me a divorce.
Does that matter?
Well, a woman wants a little security.
Hey, with your looks, you don't have to worry about that.
Looks don't last forever.
Well, nothing does.
Some things do.
Okay, name one.
Death?
You know, I never met anyone like you.
Not even that girl you came out here to help?
Not even her.
And you have no parents, no relatives. Nobody except yourself.
Just me and my shadow.
We've talked a lot about Leo. You've never seen him.
And I don't want to.
I'd like you to look at this picture of him.
That's scary. I didn't know two guys could look this much alike.
I told you.
Yeah, but...
You thought I was laying it on for your benefit.
I guess.
And now?
I believe you couldn't tell us apart.
I guess this was in the back of my mind ever since I first saw your face.
What was?
How would you like to be Mr. Leo Winters?
Oh, no way. I'd like being Al Grissom.
Then you can't be married to Mrs. Gloria Winters.
I thought we were talking about divorce.
You'll have to believe me that Leo won't give me a divorce.
Now, go back again to me being Leo Winters. That was where you lost me.
Well, you've seen his picture. Don't you see how easy it would be to take his place?
Yeah, fine, but what happens to him?
Well, that's the problem, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the problem.
I thought maybe you could think of a way out.
Yeah, I can, but I don't like it.
Try it on me.
No, I think you've already tried it on, and you like it.
Maybe.
Not maybe, positively. That's what you wanted to lay on me when you said you wanted to talk.
You're not only sexy, but you're smart.
Yeah, you bet. Smart enough to stay away from murder.
Well, who said anything about murder?
I did, my lovely. I did. I said murder. And I also said no way.
But that's stupid. You don't even know Leo.
You're really serious about trying to get rid of him.
Oh, think of what it would be like. Mr. and Mrs. Leo Winters, you and me, happily married for the rest of our lives.
Now, you jumped about 3 tracks and a couple of miles. You're too far down the road.
Why?
How did you get Leo to let you come and see me? Did you tell him we were playing backgammon or chess?
Oh, I've told you about Leo.
Well, tell me more.
Well, you know how greedy he is. He thinks that you're going to make him a lot of money with your connections in the Chicago markets.
He does, huh?
No, he's drooling about it.
Okay, but we've still got a little problem to solve about his departure.
Ah, then you're interested.
Lady, if I hadn't been interested, either you or I would have been long gone from this room. You must have been thinking about this for some time.
I have.
And you must have come up with some ideas.
I have.
Well, I'd like to hear them before I commit myself.
You will. But I promised Leo I'd be back at 3:30 sharp. That doesn't give us enough time to discuss it now.
No, but it does give us enough time to...
Seal the bargain?
Once you agree to discuss the idea of murdering someone, you've taken the first step along a road that is full of hairpin turns, some of which don't even have warning signs. We'll be back shortly with Act Two. me again. And we're talking about murder. That is, we're not talking about it. But Gloria Winters and Al Grissom are trying to arrange a murder. It isn't a simple task, as you will hear.
No. No, hiring a killer is just setting yourself up for big trouble.
Well, do you have any better ideas?
No, not yet.
You'd better come up with one, because Leo's getting suspicious.
Oh.
You don't have a gun.
Now, we've been through that.
Well, you could buy one.
And it can be traced.
Not if we get rid of it afterwards.
Gloria, I know the way the police operate. When a husband gets knocked off, the first one they check out is his wife. And statistics show they have a better than even chance of being right.
But I'm going to say it was a prowler.
Now, what makes you think they'll believe you?
Hey.
Hmm?
I've got it. I've got it. Why didn't I think of this before? The same thing that happened to you before, only this time, it'll be fatal.
Hit and run?
Of course.
You know, the more we talk, the more I'm beginning to think we ought to forget about the whole thing.
No.
All right. What car are we going to use?
Well, we'll rent one under a false name.
Mm-hmm. And who's going to rent it?
Well...
Now, you see, the guy who rents either one of us a car will remember us. And even if we give a false name...
But why should they be worried if they get the car back?
Because the hit-and-run will be discovered. They'll start asking questions.
Well, I'll be home with a friend as a witness.
No. Hit-and-run is a crime. They'll go looking for the driver of the car, and that has to be me. No, I don't like anything we've come up with. And we've got to stop thinking about murder. The cops are going to be looking for somebody and continue to think of more than an accident.
Hit and run
isn't natural. Nobody's going to dig much into what looks like a natural death. If we could get a doctor to sign a death certificate, we'd have it made.
I know a doctor.
Oh? Well, he can't be in on it. He's got to think it's death from some kind of natural cause.
I said I know a doctor.
Who?
His name is Carmody, Hugh Carmody. He's about 85 years old. He's our family doctor. He was my mother's doctor when I was born.
Is he still practicing?
Well, not really. But he refuses to give up the families he's treated for years. So he still looks after me and Leo, sort of inherited him when we got married.
Mm-hmm.
No idea?
Just a glimmer. Would this doctor believe you?
Oh, of course. Come on, let me in on it.
Okay. What do you know about poisons?
Practically nothing.
Yeah, well, that makes us even. Now, what we need is some kind of poison that looks like he died of a stroke or a heart attack or maybe some kind of food poisoning.
Mushrooms.
What?
Toadstools, mushrooms. They're poisonous.
Yeah, but he's not going to eat them.
He will if I cook them.
Yeah, that might... No. He'll get suspicious if you give them to him and you don't eat them.
Well, we need to know more about poison mushrooms. The library. I'll go there.
Out of your mind? You go asking for a book about mushrooms and then call in this doctor to look at Leo who's just eaten some bad mushrooms.
All right. I understand. But I still got to... I'll see you later.
Where are you going?
To find out what I want. And nobody will ever know.
Where have you been?
To see Dr. Carmody.
Of all the dumb places.
Relax, darling, and give me a kiss. I think I really have something.
What did you do?
toadstool. A fleshy fungus that is poisonous or inedible as distinguished from an edible mushroom.
Oh, great. We knew that before you left.
But we didn't know that aconite, which was... formerly much used as a cardiac and respiratory sedative, is the poison that comes from toadstool, or monk's hood, and can be deadly.
You didn't ask?
Of course not. I know that Dr. Carmody always visits his few patients between 3 and 4, so I went to his office and told the nurse I wasn't feeling well.
Yeah.
She knows me and let me in to wait in his office. And he has a lot of books. So I read.
Yeah, and what did you tell Carmody when he came back?
Oh, he's such an old love. I made up a story about being tired and not feeling well, and he gave me a tonic, which I'm going to get.
You know, maybe we're getting somewhere.
Oh, we're there, darling. We are there.
All right, slow up. Now, first, where can we get the aconite?
Aconite.
Yeah, that's it.
Suppose I told you we don't have to get it.
Well, I'd like to hear why.
Okay. My dad had a bad heart.
Oh, how long ago was that?
About 7 years.
And you're telling me that this Dr. Carmody prescribed aconite?
Right.
Well, how do you know the stuff's still good?
I don't.
Well, it doesn't seem to be.
Well, this is the only way we can handle it. If it doesn't work, we won't get into any trouble. And if it does, we won't get into any trouble either. So what have we got to lose?
You know, when you put it that way...
Do you know any other way?
No.
Then let's try it.
Okay, okay, let's work it out.
Okay, day after tomorrow, Thursday, that's Eileen's night out.
Right.
I'll buy the mushrooms tomorrow. Then I'll cook a great steak dinner with all the trimmings. And Leo and I will eat it.
And you too?
Of course, I'll have to.
Mm-hmm.
I won't eat too much, though. But enough to make me a little sick.
Yeah.
Then when Leo begins to feel sick, I'll suggest we call the doctor.
Carmody.
Of course, Carmody. He'll come and ask about what we ate, and I'll say steak and mushrooms, and he'll say, mushrooms? And right away, diagnose mushroom poisoning and give us something.
Yeah, I'm with you so far. And then?
And then after he leaves, I'll tuck dear old Leo into bed, tell him I have to go to the drugstore to get something. I'll go down and let you in.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, what do you need me for?
We're in this together, my love. And I want you there.
Yeah, I'd damn well better disappear after Leo dies.
That will be just fine. And we'll set up a very, very romantic meeting place.
That's real good coffee, Gloria.
Thank you, darling.
You really should have made that pie. I gotta watch my figure.
I know how much you love it. You want to go into the den?
Not particularly. So...
What?
You feel all right.
I feel fine.
Are you sure those mushrooms were good?
Of course.
I don't know. I feel kind of funny.
Even if they weren't, it's too soon for them to act up.
How do you know?
Oh, I've known about mushrooms since I was a kid.
Well, all the same, I've got pains in my stomach. Call Dr. Carmody. You really think it's the mushrooms, Doctor?
I know it's the mushrooms. It has to be. Both of you ate them, and you tell me, Leo, that you ate more than Gloria.
Yeah, that's right. That's what I get for being a pig.
Well, you're going to be all right. Just stay in bed, and Gloria, you get this prescription filled.
What about the pain?
I'm giving you a sedative also. Yeah, what I can't understand is how you cooked those mushrooms in the first place, Gloria. Your mother told you about those things when you were a child.
Well, I know, and I feel just awful. I can't explain how it happened, but I'm sorry. I have no excuse.
No use crying over spilt milk. Yeah, I better get home to bed. You get that prescription filled, young lady.
Oh, I will. Let me take you to your car.
Hello?
Are you ready to come over and sit with a sick friend?
It worked.
Like a charm.
How was Dr. Carmody?
Just as we planned. He diagnosed mushroom poisoning. Bawled me out gently. But we're lucky. That visit to his office paid off.
How will I get into your house?
Well, you know where the house is?
Yeah, I do.
Park 3 blocks away on Green Tree Lane.
Mm-hmm.
You know that little place I told you about off the road?
Yeah, I remember.
But don't walk the streets. Just cut across the fields.
Mm-hmm.
Head straight north. You better take a flashlight. Ours will be the first house you come to. The back door will be open.
Okay, I'm on my way.
Make it fast as you can. I think Leo heard me come back. He'll be yelling for his medicine. Shut the door.
Okay.
Did you lock it?
No, that's a good idea.
Here, let me. I'm waiting for the kettle to boil.
Why?
Well, you don't think I can give him this stuff straight, do you?
Well, why not? He's expecting medicine, isn't he?
He won't taste it in his tea. He likes it sweet. And I am going to make it very sweet there. Hand me the cup.
You know, I could do with a cup of tea myself.
How about something stronger?
Oh, you got something?
Oh, we're completely equipped.
Oh, don't forget to wash out the glass and put it away.
Don't worry.
All right. Hey, that's plenty. Have to be able to walk straight.
Drink as much as you want. I'll finish what you leave.
Gloria!
Yes, dear?
What happened to the medicine?
I'd better get upstairs. I'll be right back. Save me a drink?
Yeah, how long will it take?
Oh, don't ask me, Al, darling. It's the first time for me, too.
This liquor tastes funny. You know, I'm imagining things. I better finish before she gets back. Hey, I feel funny. I better sit down.
Al, what happened?
I'm sorry. I made so much noise. I don't feel too good.
Don't worry about the noise, Al. It's all right with me.
What?
Well, I guess the aconite wasn't too old, Al.
Stupid. This was a setup all the way.
All the way. I must admit, you did make it tough.
Not as tough as you made it for me. You know, you're a hell of a...
Dame. You're right, Al.
No, not Dame. I was going to say a hell of a liar.
It wasn't all lies, Al. I'm expensive. And there is $1 million life insurance policy. And when I saw your face, I realized that this was just too good an opportunity to miss.
You know, there's a little something I...
Help me get him upstairs and into my bed.
Yes, dear.
It's no time to get hysterical.
No, I'm not. It's just funny to me that Al's going to wind up just where he wanted, in your bed.
A murder has been accomplished. The happy couple, Leo and Gloria Winters, still have a way to go before they achieve their goal. But murder sometimes makes for strange and uneasy bedfellows. We'll return shortly with Act Three. Scottish poet Robert Burns' oft-quoted line, "The best-laid schemes of mice and men off gang a glee," doesn't seem to apply here. Leo and Gloria Winters have successfully killed Al Grissom, a man who looked enough like Leo Winters to have been his twin. They've carried him up to Leo's bed, and now at 4 o'clock in the morning, a frantic Gloria has summoned her sleepy and bewildered family doctor, for whom she plays the distraught and bereaved wife.
I don't understand.
Oh, neither do I, Doctor. I gave him the medicine you prescribed, and he seemed to feel better. And he dropped off to sleep, and he...
I think you'd do well to take that sedative yourself.
It's all my fault if I hadn't given him...
No, it's no one's fault, Gloria. If there's any blame attached to the tragedy, it's mine. But certainly his symptoms earlier didn't seem to warrant more action than I took.
Leo's gone. I killed him. Gosh.
Gloria?
I'm sorry, Doctor.
All right, it's perfectly understandable in this situation. Now, I want you to take this sedative and go downstairs and lie down. I'll attend to everything.
All right, I will. Thank you.
Ever told you how clever you are?
Not more than 1,000,000 times in the last week.
That's an exaggeration.
So?
So I love you.
You should. Without me, would we be here on Riviera and France, living the way we've always wanted, with $1 million, and the whole world waiting to see that we enjoy ourselves?
Do you think we can ever go back to the States?
Well, I don't want to. Do you, Leo?
What's the Leo?
I'm sorry. I've been pretty good though lately, haven't I, Al?
You've been great. You must have really been good with old Doc Carmody, too.
Oh, he was so upset and so confused. I threw the most beautiful fit of hysterics you ever saw.
Wish I could have seen it.
Oh, so broken up. So he insisted on handling everything, even the insurance people. He never gave him a chance to question anything. He signed the death certificate and had the body out of the house and into the crematorium before they ever got there.
What about returning to the U.S.?
Oh, I don't think we should for a while. Maybe in a couple of years, But never to Udalia. Maybe San Francisco. New York.
We'll see. How about a dip?
Al! Huh? Al Grissom. A pleasure to see you again, Al. How you doing? Now, that's a silly question. I can see you're doing great. No one stays at a class hotel like this unless he's doing great. But I always said you had class, Al. Yes, and style. Oh, you want to introduce me to the girl who's hanging on to you?
I'm afraid you've got the wrong man.
Don't you mean you're afraid I got the right one, Al?
Look, I don't know you. I've never seen you before in my life.
Now, you're not being smart, Al, and you were always very smart. That is, until 3 months ago, when you made your first mistake.
Hey, come on, darling, let's get away from this.
You forget it. You're finished with that getting away stuff.
Well, how can I prove to you that you've made a mistake? My name isn't Al Grissom.
Al!
You're registered under a false name? Come on, Al, I'd recognize you anywhere. But I still can't figure why you didn't try some kind of face job. But, like I said, you haven't played this very smart from the beginning.
Look, mister...
Oh, the name is Grafton. Lou Grafton. And I'll meet you at the Promenade Cafe in an hour. 1 hour, Al. And you be there.
Who is this guy?
Don't ask me.
Yeah, who should I ask?
Maybe Al.
Very funny. Didn't Al ever mention this Lou Grafton? Must have said something.
Nothing.
Well, I don't believe you.
But why would I lie?
I don't know. But you certainly were cozy enough with Al.
I found out what I had to. What we had talked about. He had no family, no relatives, nothing, nobody to trace.
I'd better meet this guy and find out what he's talking about.
I'll go with you.
I don't think that's smart.
We're in it together, Al. Who knows? I may even be able to help.
Glad you could make it, Al. Sit down.
This is Gloria.
Nice meeting you again, Gloria. Tell her you'll meet her in a little while, Al.
She's in on this.
On the whole deal?
Yes.
You certainly changed, Al. You never put a dame on the spot before.
On the spot? Oh, well, look. All I meant is that she's with me. You've made a mistake, and I don't even know what you're talking about.
Darling, why don't we listen to what he has to say?
Smart.
Al, this is the only time I'm going to go soft. The only time. Man, because we've known each other so long, and... Well, because we didn't pull it off the first time. Now, I've talked to John. I got him to agree that if you give us the whole take, we'll forget about what happened.
The whole take?
The whole $2 million, Al. All of it. Well?
Yeah, I'm trying to think.
What's there to think about? What's your alternative? You gonna try to run again? You know we'll get you. You've seen it happen 100 times to other guys who've tried to cross us. You just tell us where and when we can pick up the cash. And just thank God that I could make the deal for you.
It isn't all that easy.
What's your problem?
It's no use. You wouldn't believe
it. If you got a problem, you know we can help, but don't give me any fairy tales.
Any time.
For what?
To think.
There's nothing to think about.
No, from what you say.
How much time?
Another day.
Oh, no deal.
Look. If you want to do business with me, you'll just have
tonight,
to...
you'll be in your room at 10. There's plenty of time to think. And while you're at it, think about doing it our way. Or this time, you'll really end up very dead.
$2 million.
That's a lot of dollars.
And you're a big help.
Well, I might be if you'd stop repeating the figures over and over again.
There's no way we can get $2 million. I've got to prove to them that I'm not Al Grissom. Then they'll leave us alone.
And how do you do that?
Of course. Fingerprints. I'll have absolute proof. Even those guys will delete fingerprints.
And who's going to tell them? You?
No. I've got to arrange somehow for the police to send my prints to Washington or somewhere.
And the police will get word back that these aren't the fingerprints of Al Grissom, but really the prints of a man named Leo Winters, who supposedly died 1 month ago, and whose widow collected $1 million in life insurance.
You're right. That's the only way to go. How do we convince him I'm not Grissom?
I don't know. We went to a lot of trouble to prove to the world that you were.
Who was this Grissom? He must have been awfully big to get into a deal like this.
I think he must be calling you.
Me?
Who else?
Well, I don't want to answer.
Well, that's not smart. They know we're here.
Now, don't start talking like Grafton. Hello.
Al, it's me.
What do you want?
Al, I was wondering whether you'd made up your mind.
Not yet.
It's 9 o'clock.
Who said 10?
I did, but John's not happy.
What do I care about John?
You should, Al. After all, he's got a real legitimate beef. You worked for him for years. You were always clean. You took the hot stocks and you cashed them. You made money and so did we, but I guess the $2 million got to you.
Look, I've got some more thinking to do and I'll see you at 10.
Well?
I know who and what Grissom was. He took hot stocks and bonds and cashed them and then turned the cash over to...
The boys?
I suppose you could call him that.
Does that help any?
A little, maybe.
How?
At least we know what they're after. If there was some way we could trap them, some way to fool them.
Well, suppose there were, then what?
I don't know yet. But play along with me when Grafton comes up at 10. Yes?
Grafton. You finished thinking?
All finished.
And?
I'll go along with you.
Now, why couldn't you have told me that this morning? You had to get John's blood pressure up.
Forget John. I told you I had problems.
And I told you would help.
I don't have the $2 million with me.
We never figured you did. Where is it, Chicago?
I'll pick it up.
When?
As soon as I can.
Will you stop playing games? When?
It's back in the States.
Okay. Now, you'll get the next plane.
Now, not so fast. It's somewhere in Eudalia, and I can't go back there.
Why not?
A little something. The cops might want to talk to me.
About what?
About a girl I visited there, and an old friend.
What's wrong with visiting an old friend?
Nothing. If you don't get caught by her husband and get into a fight, beat him up, and he calls the cops.
That's not much of a rap.
That's right. But you don't want to see me in jail.
Yeah, you got a point. We'll pick up the dough.
No way.
Why not? We're going to get it anyway.
You're going to get it. But I want some assurance that I'm going to be okay.
You have my word.
Well, I'd like a little more than that.
Like what?
That's what I've been trying to figure out. Some way I'll be sure that...
Look, if you haven't figured it out by now, you're not going to. Well, I get the plane tickets.
You sure don't give me much time.
We gave you time before, Al. Too much time.
Will you stop pacing up and down like an animal?
Gloria, I think I may have an idea.
I hope.
On the plane, I'll tell them I figured it out. Since I can't go back to Eudalia, I'll insist that I want someone representing me when they pick up the money.
But there is no money.
They don't know that. I'll insist that you go along.
Hold it.
You'll be all right.
What happens when they find out there isn't any money and I'm there and you're not?
Put in a call to Carmody. Tell him you can't get over what's happened, that you need help, and that you've gotten into some kind of trouble. He should have the police there. Then you take them to the doctor's house, and with the cops there, you'll be in the clear.
And you?
I'll be gone. I'd rather be alive and running than the other way.
I don't like it.
Then think of something better, because that's the way I'm going to play it.
Crazy ideas at this stage of the game, but just in case you do, these two young fellas here are in our party, and they'll be on the plane with us all the way to Chicago.
Thanks.
Flight 396 to New York, now loading at gate 3. Flight 396,
yeah,
now
let's
loading
go.
At gate 3.
Excuse me. One moment, please.
What do you want?
Lieutenant Fourneau, Interpol. I believe you are Mr. Leo Winters.
I'm afraid you're mistaken. I've known this man for years. His name is Al...
Mr. Winters.
You heard him. You've got the wrong man.
Please, don't make a fuss, Mr. Winters. I'm instructed to hold you for the murder of an Alvin Grissom in New Delhi.
Oh, hold me. What about her? She's my wife, and she was in on this from the beginning. The whole thing.
We know all about Mrs. Winters. In fact, she was the one who informed us about the murder in return for some small promises.
She told? She...
You asked me, remember? You said, think of something better. And I did.
Come along, Mr. Winters. Gentlemen, you'll excuse us.
I'm coming, Lieutenant. I'm coming without any trouble. You see, Grafton, you didn't believe me. If you'd only have believed me, maybe we could have worked out a deal after all.
The Winters had a good plan, and it all would have worked. Except for one thing they couldn't have foreseen. The bend in the road ahead and what lay around it. I'll return shortly. If Gloria and Leo Winters could have known what lay ahead of them, they would never have gone through with their plan. That is, if they could have seen into the future and around the bend. Yet actually being able to see into the future, to know what's going to happen next week, next month, next year, is a gift that most of us wouldn't want. Because who knows what terrors may lie ahead. Our cast included Leon Janney, Joan Lovejoy, Larry Haynes, Paul Hecht, and Robert Dryden. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
There are no such things as ghosts. I'm just imagining things. But I see you. I see you. Now, don't hurt me. Whatever you are, please. Stay away from me. I'll go right down the stairs, walk out of the house, and never come back. Is that what you want? Please. No! Don't touch me! Let me out!
Suicide. That's what all the papers say, Mr. Garth. But we know better. That house is haunted.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, brewers of Budweiser. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.